Whenever I start a school year, I really try to have a vision for where I want my kids to be by the end of the year. So this means I spend a lot of time backwards planning and really thinking through the particular learning objectives that feel really non-negotiable to me. Oftentimes, we have to cycle back to things because I know for me as a learner, I never learn something the very first time I do it. And if it's really important, then we have to spiral back to it so kids get repeated practice. So, for instance, if we're talking about writing and we want kids to improve something simple like using paragraphs, I'll often do an intro sort of demonstration and let them try it out, and then we'll come back to it in a more higher level way where maybe they'll do some inquiry and notice how paragraphing has improved their comprehension or their understanding of a story. And that's something that can be really embedded in any type of unit that we do across the year. And so to me, that's sort of like a high leverage thing that I want kids to think about and to learn. And really, it's easy for me to measure their progress from the beginning of the year to the end of the year. But if I want them to be successful, then I have to give them multiple goes or multiple tries so they can actually accomplish those learning objectives.
I thought I was this great explainer of things, as if that's what teaching was about, rather than now I believe that the experiences I give them, the ability for them to have conversations, that's what makes a great teacher. Not my ability to explain, but my ability to prompt them to explain their thinking to each other. And I thought that if I was a great explainer, I would explain something, I would show them how to do it, and I would ask them to do it for homework. And then we would repeat that process every day. And at the end of maybe 2 weeks, we would test ourselves on what we learned. And then we'd do that again. But I realized that kids get really good at learning something for that two-week time frame, maybe even put it somewhere in their long-term memory. But 8 months down the line, they never remembered that again. And you hear teachers saying this all the time. Oh, it's the end of summer break. They don't remember anything. Or can't test them on that. We learned that before winter break. And you just have to think, well, what was the point of teaching it to begin with if they're not going to remember it even 3 or 4 weeks later? And so now, much more in homework and even in activities in class, I make sure that I'm recalling previous ideas and incorporating them into the homework and into the lesson that we're doing. And at first, students get a little bit disoriented. Why are we writing about this? Why did you ask me about the vertex of a parabola? We did functions last week. Why is that showing up in this unit right now? But their practice in recalling that information and using it again without any reminders about what that's about helps them in the future remember that that's an important idea and helps them create and strengthen those pathways and helps them kind of navigate that forest in their mind and say, these are the relationships that I see between these ideas and I can use those again.